So today I want to revisit an app that I checked out a fair while ago. It's called Routine, and it's a planner application that wants to help you to plan your notes, tasks, and your calendar. Now the application plugs in with Outlook and Gmail, and we're going to overview what it does in this video. So I think it's always good to start with pricing because it's helpful to know what pricing we've got here. So there is a free plan, and it is a forever free plan. And they also have a professional plan, which is the only available pricing right now. And that's priced at $10 a month. With the professional pricing, you get more calendar access, views, and a few more additional abilities like data connectors and contextual capture, which is a feature on the Mac version. So just to give you a basic rundown, this application is designed to be a minimal application, but it is aiming more towards teams than ever. Last time I reviewed it, it was much more of a personal tool, but looking at the website now, it's very much tailoring or at least targeting features that are more team-based. So for example, the ability to manage projects in here and knowledge so you and your team can collaborate as well is all on the horizon for this application. So looking at what this application does on Mac, they also have an Android and iOS app as well as a Windows app and Linux app too. But in general, this application wants to help you to plan your time. So as you can see here, you can see an agenda allowing you to organize what week ahead you'd got. So today's video is kindly sponsored by Zapier. You can find those guys below. And if you're looking to get an idea for AI automations, those are the guys to go to. A little bit later in this video, we'll explore more. So over here, you have an agenda allowing you to add a task and essentially being able to drag it into a timeline-like view, which will help you to see exactly what you've got focused in your day. Now, this is almost your today area to some extent, but you can scrabble ahead if you did want to, as well as seeing additional calendar connections that you may have. Now, up here, you have something called an inbox. The inbox is a perfect place to capture stuff, and you can also be able to capture items. So for example, if I press Control-Alt-Z, you can see that this pops up here. I'll do a screenshot because it's a little bit strange looking. But essentially from here, I can see my coming up tasks, my events, and even add an item. And it's got a really good capturability for tasks and events. Now, as you can see, everything has something connected to it, and that's because they belong to an area here called notes. Now, notes are essentially just ways to structure your pages and capture stuff in. For example, got a watch list here. You can pretty much build a note out like it was a text document. There's nothing too detailed here. You can add things like a table view and a board view. So these are views that are part of the premium experience, and they look sort of like this. Although the collaboration function of this is going to extend and the knowledge management abilities are going to get better. So not really Notion, but at the same time helpful for building stuff out. You can also take in meeting notes as well here. They don't have an AI meeting extension, but at the same time, it's good for being able to bring stuff in that you've had from meetings. These are particularly event meetings, which you may want to come back to earlier. So you can tick stuff off here and it will tick off in real life. So you can turn anything inside of the notes area into a task. Now, in my opinion, I think the real power with Routine comes in the calendar area. So this is the 5-day view. You can add tasks here. So for example, wash car, and then you can drag them into your items. That's really nice. But you can also add tasks and drag them in from here. So if you want to drag stuff in or change it to week view or even go to a monthly view, you can see everything at a glance, which is really nice. So that's an additional experience to the agenda view. They have tasks as well for reoccurrences and upcoming items. So you almost get a view of what's coming up based on everything like that. Now, what's really nice as well is you can connect additional calendar applications, which is really nice. I believe there's a limit on the pricing with the Routine. And you can also connect up integrations with Notion and contextual capture, which you can set up as part of it. Contextual capture essentially sees what you're on and allows you to capture websites and things like that to what you'll be able to save at the same time. So if you're in New York Times and you're saving something about, I don't know, an idea that you've had, it'll capture what's on that page at the same time. So there's also a journal area to see things you've done, and you can manage your plans down here. Did you know that over 1.3 million people use Zapier with AI? This can help you save time, optimize repetitive tasks, and get more done. Zapier helps you to create workflows and automation by building simple or complex workflows and connecting nearly 8,000 integrations. Zapier is one of the leaders in AI automation, and that's why over 3.4 million companies use Zapier to get things done. Get started today for free down in the link in the description. So routine's a really interesting application. In terms of its pros, it's very much designed for a minimal daily planner. It's gonna be a great way for you to see and plan your week ahead in a very manual sense. There are no AI features. There's no advanced features in terms of project management or collaboration. The app is very much an individualized experience, and the free plan is fairly generous. They're also independently developed, which is good as well, and the application is very robust in terms of what it was before. The app was a little bit slower before, but it seems to be fixing a lot of that slowness, which is great for users who are using this every single day. So who I'd recommend this for? It's probably best for those who want a clean experience and not too overcomplicated. Somewhere in between Todoist and Motion without the AI elements, of course. But I like the way that they've structured the design. Reminds me a lot of Sensama without necessarily the guided planning and the heavy pricing. So I hope this video was helpful. Please do let me know if you have any comments and share your thoughts on Routine, whether you've used it in the past or whether you're thinking of using it. Feel free to find a link below.